What if Prussia existed in 1444? Hi everyone, and welcome to today's video where we're going to be seeing what would happen if Prussia existed in 1444. Before we begin, consider leaving a like and subscribing since only 12% of you are subscribed, and you can become a member today. Today's video is brought to you by Dragon City. Dragon City is free to play and it's available on Android, iOS, Windows, and Amazon. You can download Dragon City for free right now at the link in the video description. In Dragon City, you can collect thousands of different dragons and build your own Dragon City. You can breed two dragons together to get new ones, and you can also feed them to evolve them. You can also train your dragons and take them to battle in order to make them more powerful. There's also different PvP modes that let you fight against your friends and challenge other dragon masters. There are several events every week that you can discover and play new adventures on, such as Maze, Runner, Grid, and Heroic Race. My personal favorite adventure is the Maze. You can also find many popular YouTubers in Dragon City too, such as Fundy, Wisp, Dream, George Not Found, Eddie VR, and many others. By checking out the link in the description, you can claim a special free reward of 15,000 food, 30,000 gold, and the rare Citadel Dragon. For new members only and up until August 5th. So check out the link in the video description today, download Dragon City, and claim your free reward. Now back to the video. So as you can see, it's December 1st, 1444, and I have created Prussia with their 1871 borders just before the formation of Germany. Now I know these borders aren't the most accurate, and I did try to get them as accurate as possible, at least in EU4, you know, since some provinces aren't the right shape, and since there's tiny exclaves of other nations which can't be really represented in EU4. But I feel like this is as accurate as they can be in the game. So I created Prussia in 1444. They are Protestant. I did have to make them Protestant for them to have the Prussian monarchy government form. The only downside to this is that it does create a center of reformation, which I can't remove, but it's honestly not gonna be a big deal since these Catholic nations will have a very easy time converting the provinces that this center of reformation converts. I did let a month tick by so Prussia can sort of get adjusted to itself and so everything can be set up. Right now they are second on the great powers list, 2 times larger than the Mamluks, England, and the Ottomans, so as you can see, the dev in North Germany is insane. Their capital is in Königsberg. I did create it in Berlin, but they moved it themselves, I'm guessing. They have stated everything, and I did give them a little bit of extra governing capacity, just enough so they can state all these areas. They start out with 400. I think they have about 600 or 700 right now, so nothing too crazy. They can expand, but they do need to be careful, and they won't be releasing any subjects. Their main trade node is Lübeck, and they are routing from Saxony and the Baltic Sea to Lübeck. And as you can see, they're already a very powerful nation. They do have the second largest army, although they are way above force limit. Maybe they'll downsize, maybe their force limit will increase. I think they should balance out around 50 to 60,000 and not 79,000. And that's pretty much what this setup looks like. What do you think will happen? Will Prussia just stagnate and not expand a whole lot, maybe taking one or two provinces here and there? Will they actually suck and be defeated by all the surrounding nations? Or will they blob really hard and expand massively by the end of the game? As we can see, these are the provinces that they desire right now. The provinces in red, they want a lot. And the provinces in yellow, they want somewhat. Their first ruler is balanced, so he will not be expanding a whole lot, but he will be expanding a bit. I'm interested in seeing what will happen when they get a militarist ruler. And if you want this save game from December 1st, 1444, the save file is available to all YouTube members in the Save Games Discord channel. So let's get the scenario started, and we'll check back in about 40 to 50 years. So it's 1484. It has been about 40 years since the start of the game, and let's take a look at what Prussia has been up to. Basically, this is what their borders look like, and to be honest, it's pretty expected, at least for this initial period of the game where there won't be too much opportunities to expand. Basically, the first war they declared was against Lübeck, and as we can see, they have annexed Lübeck. That was a very easy war for them, although they did have to fight many nations. Basically, since Lübeck is in the HRE, they had to fight Austria and all their allies. allies. Then their second war was against Mecklenburg. Mecklenburg had these three provinces, and as we can see, they full annexed them as well. Another easy war against the HRE. Then their third war was against Poland, where they took these three provinces right here, this one, and this one. And all of that happened probably in the first 20 years of the game, so up until the 1460s somewhere. But now they are allied to the Ottomans, England, Austria, and Muscovy. Basically, probably the strongest nation in the game at this point, except for Ming, has allied all the other strongest nations. So this is what their alliances look like. At least we know they won't have any problems dealing with coalitions, but that has been their expansion so far. Like I said, pretty expected. Now, one problem with these alliances is, the only problem is their alliance with Austria. Since they are allied to Austria, they probably won't be declaring wars against members of the HRE anytime soon. And ever since they allied Austria, they haven't been doing that. Basically, their expansion route to the west and to the south is locked. They can't even go into Hungary because Austria has Hungary as a junior partner. So basically, their only route for expansion is into Poland, Lithuania, and the Livonian Order, and Denmark to the north. But if we click on the provinces that they desire, they don't even want to go into Denmark. Basically, they want to clean up some of these minor nations over here and move into Poland. And that's pretty much what's been going on so far. Prussia have picked innovative ideas for their first idea group, so we may see some actually good idea groups being picked, unless they pick espionage for their second one. So let's check back in about the 1520s or the 1530s. Now it's 1530, about 50 years have passed since we last checked in, and let's take a look at what Prussia has been up to. Basically, right after we checked in last time, Prussia immediately declared war on Poland once again, maybe about 2 or 3 years after we checked in, and they took these two provinces down here, so Krakow and this one too. And that was pretty much it, just those two provinces. After that, they were chilling for a couple of years, allying some of these smaller nations in the HRE, great power influencing them, giving them subsidies, and they did manage to diplo-vassalize Oldenburg, and later they annexed them. Right now they are influencing Rothenburg, which is right here, and Regensburg, which is right here, and I do think they will succeed in diplo-vassalizing them. So that's great, they're using other means of conquest as well. After that, they declared on Thuringia, which had these three provinces right here, which pretty much ended their alliance with Austria. As we can see, they aren't allied to Austria anymore. So in that war, they took this province from Hungary. As we know, they are a junior partner of Austria, and they full annexed Thuringia. Like I said, they had these three provinces. After that, they declared another war against Poland, in which they took these four provinces down here. So this one, and this one. Then they were chilling, and then they declared on Denmark. Funnily enough, they only took their capital of Copenhagen right here, just that one province, nothing else. Denmark does still have Sweden and Norway as junior partners, although Sweden is 100% disloyal. And sometime after that, they declared their third war against Poland, where they took these three provinces over here and these two over here. So they have been pretty active. They did have a militarist ruler, so that of course contributed a lot to how much wars they were declaring, whereas now they have an administrator, and this guy doesn't want too much land. Basically, he just wants to clean up some of the HRE miners over here. He's not into conquering Poland or Denmark right now. That's pretty much what's been going on with Prussia. The Protestant Reformation is in full swing, although it does look a lot stronger than it really is due to Prussia being Protestant, but we do have some reformed provinces, and Scotland has gone Anglican. Now, I don't know if you guys know this, but since Scotland is Anglican, that means that England rejected the event to become Anglican. When England rejects it, Scotland can also get it, and they accepted it. So this is what it's looking like right now. We'll check back in around 1580. So it's been another 50 years, it's 1583, and let's take a look at what Prussia has been doing. Now, on first glance, you might think to yourself, okay, they haven't been doing anything. Pretty boring last 50 years, right? Well, not exactly. They have taken these two provinces from Poland, and they've taken this province from I don't know which nation, although Ansbach is looking pretty strong. And then you might ask yourself, why do they have four provinces right here? Why do they have Prussian Pskov? Why do they have Neva? Why is there Prussian Earl? Well, Russia is a junior partner of Prussia. That's right, their ruler died, and they instantly fell into a PU under Prussia. No succession wars, no Prussian dynasty on their throne, nothing, just a straight up PU immediately. Which, when you think about it, isn't that rare for Russia. They are one of the nations that I see as a junior partner the most often, to be honest. So yeah, that's what's been going on. Prussia got Russia as a junior partner. They conquered some lands here, then they conquered some lands here. Of course, Prussia has been declaring these with Russia's claims, but they've been taking the provinces for themselves. I can't notice if they've actually been expanding Russia, although they might have gained some provinces here and there as well. They have a regency right now, and they don't desire a lot of lands over here, basically just some HRA miners like before, but they do desire a ton of lands over here. Basically, these are probably lands that Russia has claims on, but they will take them for themselves anyway, as we can see by these three areas right here. The absolute Chads also made Russia change their state religion to Protestant, and of course they are Protestant right now. They have been doing converting, as we can see right here and over here, and even over here in their newly conquered provinces. Of course, they will be converting everything they own, and they are completely loyal. They have been since the start. No disloyal stuff, nobody supporting their independence or stuff like that. They are also warning Lithuania and Austria, which is pretty funny since the religious leagues have formed. Now, Prussia was the leader of the Protestant League. Now they're not, because they have a regency, as we can see by that tooltip right there. And the Protestant side is much stronger than the Catholic side, as we can see right here. Although they do have some stronger nations like Austria, Spain, and Portugal. But the real strength is over here. We have Prussia and the Ottomans. What else do you need? Am I right? Even England and Scotland too. So like I said, Mainz is the leader. I really don't know why they're not declaring on Austria. Maybe we'll have to wait for Prussia to get back as the leader of the Protestant League in about 5 years when this guy becomes ruler, and then they might declare on Austria. So let's see if that really happens, and we'll jump back in if the religious league fires, and if not, we'll be back in around 1630 when the age of absolutism is in full swing. So it's just a couple of years after we checked in and the war of the Protestant League has fired. Mainz did declare on Austria. Let's see what the sides look like. And this is basically what it looks like. It's pretty huge. Even the Great Horde and the Timurids are involved. Honestly, I've never seen nations this far out get involved. Of course, it's pretty common for the Ottomans to participate, but that's about as far as it stretches. And of course, the biggest factor is that France and Spain aren't participating. So this looks like an easy win for the Protestant side. And I do think that Protestant will become the official faith of the HRE. Of course, that can lead to things like Prussia getting elected emperor. So that's what it's looking like. And we'll check back in the 1530s, and then we'll see who won. All right, so it's 1623. As we can see, the Timurids, they're not doing so well. Now here's something I want to know. I want to know, how did this happen? Look at this. Look at how many nations are in a coalition against the Timurids. They're losing three wars right now. Basically, they're at war with, well, pretty much the entire world. And this has got to be some sort of bug. I have seen one or two Reddit posts like this, but come on. Is Shoshone really in a coalition against the Timurids? Anyway, they're losing a punitive war to Adalan right now, to Bahmanis, and to the Mamluks. This is everyone they're at war with. If anyone knows how this happens, please let me know. I have seen it happen to Vijayanagar, like I said, on a Reddit post. Either way, Prussia is doing fine. The religious war ended and the Protestants won. Of course, that was expected. They haven't conquered much here. In fact, they haven't conquered anything here at all. Here is where they've been focusing though, in this region right here. Basically in the Ural and in the Pontic Steppe, Russia and Ruthenia as well. So this has been their main base of expansion. Basically all the provinces that they desired earlier when we looked at this map mode. They are in a war with the Great Horde right now, and they have started to integrate Russia. Here's another interesting thing though. Their dynasty, this Vorade dynasty right here, is also on the British throne. So we might see them PU Great Britain too, which would be pretty crazy to be honest. Or we might see Britain PU them, which would be a sort of cursed end to this campaign. I swear it's so funny seeing Iceland be in a coalition against the Timurids. They have a colony too, Vinland. I guess they've been doing some colonizing. This game is looking more and more cursed by the second. And we'll check back in around 1680. So now it's 1680, about 50 years after we last checked in. So let's take a look at what Prussia has been up to. And even from this level of being zoomed out, well, we can see this. So we know at least half of what they were up to. Basically, Prussia did finish integrating Russia, and now we have Ah yes, Prussian Eastern Europe. Very good name placement. And they have been expanding some more in this region. You guys remember that the lands that they desired were mostly around this region. They've even made it down here into the Transcaspia area. And they have been expanding here in the Pontic Steppe as well. Not too much into Lithuania though. Mostly the Ottomans have been taking over Lithuania and Poland. Of course, thanks to their alliance with Prussia, they are also really strong. Now that's not the only thing that happened. Remember how I said that Great Britain had Prussia's dynasty? Well, that's what's been going on, and they've even started integrating them. They got it not too long after we last checked in. Basically, there was a succession war this time, so they didn't get it straight up just like Russia. Sweden of all nations contested it. Of course, Sweden needed to siege down London for them to get the war goal. Of course, that's impossible. Prussia and Russia just crushed them, and of course, they had no chance in naval invading Great Britain. So we have that. Great Britain is a junior partner under Prussia, and they are integrating them. They've also taken some provinces over here from France, and they even own Paris. They haven't been doing much expansion over here in their starting area, almost none at all actually, and they've mostly been expanding in lands that they took surrounding their subjects. They've even been declaring some wars over here, although they haven't been winning them because, well, they just weren't getting over here, but they had some wars against these nations on Borneo. So we have Granada. They still exist. I'm really wondering if this is their only province. No, it's not actually. Their capital is right here, and they seem to have only these two provinces, which is hilarious. Have you guys ever seen Granada immigrate this far away? I've seen them in Africa a couple of times, but never over here. We also have another PU. Spain is a junior partner under Portugal. They did have the same Leon dynasty. Their ruler died. I don't think there was a succession war or anything like that. Another straight up PU. So now Portugal is really strong too. They're number three on the great powers. They haven't been meddling in European affairs, but they have been fighting native nations in South and North America. And we'll check back in 1730 when the Age of Revolutions is in full swing. Will we see revolutionary Prussia? Probably not, but let's hope so. So it's 1730, and I'm sad to inform you that Prussia doesn't exist anymore because they formed Germany. Have you guys ever seen this? Now, I know they started out with a pretty big portion of land in northern Germany, almost all of it, but did anyone really think that they would be able to form Germany? Not me, and I'll give you my thoughts on that later on. But I've personally never seen an AI Germany, and there we go, Prussia just did it. They formed Germany. I think the only thing missing were a couple of provinces down here. Now, I don't know the exact requirements to form Germany off the top of my head like this, but they were probably missing some provinces down here, or they needed a certain number of provinces to form it, but they did form it. And now we have Germany's Europe. Yep, that's right. Either way, after they formed Germany, they did become a lot more active in conquering provinces in Europe. Now, I do think they get a bunch of claims, and let's see right here. Yep, that's true. They have claims on a bunch of regions in Europe, except for Iberia and the Balkans, I'm guessing, and maybe Ruthenia. But they have claims on so much lands right here. So what they did basically was, I think they immediately rivaled the Ottomans after they became Germany, and they're still rivaled as we can see. But basically they vassalized Hungary, they integrated them by now. They also have Crimea as a subject. They've been conquering more provinces here, so Hungary wasn't this big. They had a few provinces. They took these provinces right here, some provinces here in southern Germany, as well as some in the lowlands. And they also conquered a bunch of provinces in Italy, as we can see these right here, and this one here too. This isn't the only region where they've been active. They have been conquering a lot more in Asia as well, mostly over here, conquering from Chagatai and the Timurids. And they just finished a war with Ming. In fact, we can see that their armies are pretty much still here. We even have one British army right here. And they have been conquering a lot in Asia too. So they are very, very big now. Another cool thing that happened is I think Bahmanis formed Deccan. I've also never seen an AI Deccan, so that's really, really awesome as well. And this is another very powerful nation. Right now they are integrating Great Britain. It should be done in around 40 to 50 years by my guess. They also have Crimea as a vassal, like I said, and they have finally removed all their provinces from the HRE. Well, almost all of them. And we can see the provinces that they desire, basically all the provinces they have claims on, and then some here in the Balkans as well as Ruthenia, even in Anatolia, the Caucasus, and all over their border in Asia. Basically, we are in the Age of Revolutions, and we do have some revolutionary countries. Actually, we have revolutionary Luka right here, and I think revolutionary Regensburg too. Flags are disgusting as always. Please, Paradox, change the way revolutionary flags are designed. So it's 1783, and right away we can see that Germany has been expanding quite a lot. So let's take a look at everything they've done so far. Okay, so first I need to mention, you guys remember how they were integrating Great Britain earlier? Well, they're still here and they're a vassal. Basically what happened is Germany integrated Great Britain. You can also see that because they have their colonies right now, but I guess they were over governing capacity or something, so they released them as a vassal, and these are all the lands they have, as well as down here, and they're 100% disloyal, and they have been 100% disloyal ever since they released them. So that's something dumb that they did. I don't think they'll be integrating them again by the end of the game. Either way, they have been doing some expanding. As we can see, they've taken over almost all of France. Of course, we can say that they own the red parts too, but this is what's left of France and of Burgundy. Basically, they've been expanding here. They've been expanding some more in Italy as well. Oh wait, no they haven't, that's just Provence. But they have been fighting the Ottomans quite a lot. As we can see, they've taken provinces from them over here, some provinces here too, and down here as well. I don't think they declared on the HRE, not even once since we last checked in, so I guess they've been focusing elsewhere. And where would they be focusing if not in Asia? I mean, look at how far they've advanced into Persia. All their armies are here, so they must have been in a war recently over here, and now they just declared on Venice, and they're at war with Venice, Lithuania, France, and Provence. They've been fighting Ming even more, Chagatai even more. They basically own almost all of Mongolia and Central Asia right now. Ming are really declining. They even lost a couple of wars to Manchu. As we can see, they're pretty big. Like I said, they were formed by Hai Shi, not a nation that forms them that often. Usually it's Zhangzhou. And Deccan has been expanding quite a lot. I actually didn't notice Bengal, they're huge too, so shout out to Bengal and Deccan too. Can one of them form Bharat or Hindustan? I don't think so, but it's still cool to see. And we'll check back in 1821 for our final jump in time. So it's January 3rd 1821, the end of this scenario. And let's go over everything that has happened. Basically, Prussia started out in this region here, mainly in northern Germany, with their borders just before the formation of the German Empire. Now, honestly, they surprised me a lot. Going into this scenario, I had zero confidence. You know, everyone's always like, oh my god, AI Prussia formed, blah blah blah, this and that. Of course, they are one of the strongest nations militarily, but I had zero confidence in the AI to do well. I thought they would suck, collapse, maybe not expand that much, grab a few provinces here and there, but mostly just stagnate, because like I said, I'm not confident in the AI at all. But Prussia surprised me, and in a very good way. Basically, in the beginning, they didn't expand too much, taking a few provinces from Poland here and there, a little bit from Denmark, pushing a little bit into the HRE, nothing too much. They were prevented from attacking them because they did ally Austria in the beginning. And you guys remember, they allied Austria, the Ottomans, Great Britain, and Russia. Now, allying Russia and Great Britain, mostly Russia, is the best thing they ever did. A little bit before the mid-game, they got a PU over Russia, and that is basically what enabled them to expand this much and be this powerful. Would they still be really strong without the PU over Russia? To be honest, I don't know. I think they would still continue to expand in Poland, maybe a little bit in the HRE. Maybe they would have still formed Germany, but definitely they wouldn't have expanded in Asia as much as they did. And here's what they own right now. Basically, they formed Germany, as you know. They own most of the provinces in the two Germany regions. They expanded a lot into Poland, vassalized and annexed Hungary, pushed into the Ottomans. They've even taken provinces down here. They do own most of Italy. They own most of France, and they have Great Britain as a vassal. They got a PU over them as well. They integrated them and released them, and they have quite a few colonies too, like Colombia, Alaska, and Newfoundland. This colony down here, which is occupied by Portugal obviously, this one right here, and this one right here. Of course, they inherited them from Great Britain. Now, because of the fact they got a PU over Russia, that enabled them to expand in Asia. First off, they pushed over here in this region mainly. After that, they set their sights over here, taking over Mongolia, Central Asia, and even pushing down to Persia. And they are the biggest country, well, maybe the biggest, with the exception of Portugal. They started out number 2 on the Great Powers list with around 600 to 700 dev. Now they're number 1 with 7,500, followed by Portugal, the Ottomans, Bengal, Deccan, Morocco, Holland, and Manchu. And they are an economic hegemon. They were a military hegemon a couple of decades ago, but I guess they swapped. Some other interesting things that happened are Portugal got a PU over Spain. As we can see, they've already integrated them. They own almost all of South America and most of North America too. Bahmanis formed Deccan. That's a very cool thing that happened. I haven't seen AI Deccan. Bengal is huge. They've conquered so much, so huge shout out to them. Haishi from Manchu, that's pretty awesome as well. And Japan have expanded quite a bit over here. And shout out to Lanshang too. They've grown quite a bit as well. They kept their capital as Königsberg the entire game. Like I said, I did set it up in Berlin. They moved it themselves over here and it's at 233 development. Now, who said there are no monuments in Königsberg? We have the Inukshuk, the Stonehenge, and the Buddha statue. So all the movable monuments, with the exception of one, I think, they moved over here. This is what the religion map mode looks like. Of course, Protestant would be dominant. They were Protestant the whole game. They did force Protestant on Russia and Great Britain, and they were converting for them as well. As we can see, they still haven't converted provinces over here, but that's totally fine. Going into the ledger, they do have the biggest army with over 2 million troops, and their force limit is 2,200, and they have 740,000 manpower. That's pretty awesome. This is one of the biggest AI armies I've ever seen. Usually in these videos, nations will get up to 1 million, something like that, but they have 2 million. Of course, they do have the largest income by far, with more than 1,900 ducats a month, followed by Ottomans, Portugal, Bengal, Deccan, Great Britain, and so on. So, what would happen if Prussia existed in 1444? Well, obviously, they would go on to form Germany and become the most powerful country in the world. Of course, this was aided by their PUs on Russia and Great Britain, but still huge shout out to them. Like I said just a moment ago, I had zero expectations for AI Prussia. I thought they would suck, but they surprised me very pleasantly, so huge shout out to them. And honorable mentions to Deccan, Bengal, Portugal, and Morocco. They seem to be doing pretty well. If you want this save game and you want to play Prussia in 1444, the save file is available to all YouTube members in the Save Games Discord channel. And also, don't forget to check out Dragon City at the link in the video description. Like I said, it's free to play and you can claim your exclusive free reward today. Let me know in the comments below what's the next what if scenario that I should do a video about. If you enjoyed this video, don't hesitate to leave a like and subscribe, since only 12% of you are subscribed, and you can become a member today and join the Discord. The link is in the description. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time with another EU4 video.